the game in Mbale. Mbale Heroes winning against AC Villa, picking their first win in Mbale after over 20 years. That was the first time Premier League football was returning in Mbale, and it did not disappoint. From a solo strike, 85th minute strike from Waiswa Kosea, an interesting player, left a player also who played for Mida FC and also Chetume FC, some stints in Somalia. Yeah, but it was an interesting game, especially looking at what Mbale Heroes presented to us. We've been wondering, what is Mbale Heroes doing in the market? What is it that Mbale Heroes is trying to cook? But that the game on Sunday against Villa, you would see new players. Faisal Wabiona, I mean, Wabiona was at KCCA, but he slipped under the radar of many Premier League teams. And I'm happy for Mr. Chris and Badru, the management of Mbale Heroes, to really scout these players. I don't know whether they're getting them on loan or permanent basis. You look at Kagwa in there, Malik Bironse, the son of Abedi Bironse, Mbale Heroes legend. You're looking at Matata Jeremy, very, very difficult player on the right. Actually, his crosses really caused Aslam, the Sevilla left back, a lot of trouble. There's something about these Mbale Heroes that, for me, I feel that we should keep an eye on them. There are teams that it will be hard to really pick full results in Mbale for the teams that will be visiting in Mbale.
In that game, of course, in that game, we saw Mbale getting that set piece, a good free kick taken by Waiswa. And before that free kick was taken, the fans were busy screaming, the goal is going to enter. What next? The goal entered. And it was a good set piece. It was a good free kick scored by Waiswa. On top of that, I'm just happy that these community clubs are doing something incredible, which I'm sure Dumparaka, if they come back now, I'm sure they've learned something. Be like, you know, these are community clubs. We saw Mbale, of course, writing a statement saying they got 15 million from that game of Mbale versus AC Villa, which was something so interesting. And today morning, I saw a post from Clive Chiazze, whereby Deo Kasozi was appealing to URA to not tax clubs when it comes to get collections. And I'm happy that he has talked about it, because URA may try so fast, but you know what? Clubs are getting a lot of money, we need to tax them. This money is coming from the fans, and these are community clubs. This money is going to help the clubs in a lot of things, and we need to make sure our football is developing every now and then. So.